Sesame Street. How to get to Sesame Street.
Hi, Olivia.
Hello, Bert. How are you?
Okay, where's Mr. Hooper?
Oh, we had to go and deliver some groceries, so he asked me to mind a store for him.
Oh, I see.
What can I do for you?
Well, I'll take the usual.
The usual?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know what the usual is.
Oh, of course. Well, I would like a glass of soda water, please.
Uh-huh.
No fizz, flat.
Soda water, no fizz,
flat. Mm-hmm.
But it's so plain that way.
Well, that's what I like.
But wouldn't you like a little cherry syrup in it? A little ice cream on top?
No, don't. Just no fizz, flat. I like it that way.
All right. That's the way you want it. I mean, you're entitled to have it any way you like,
Don't shake it up too much.
Oh, well, it's flat. It's flat. But you know, I bet you're the only person in the world that likes it that way. I have never met anybody else who likes plain flat soda water. I can't understand that. Never. Not little syrup, little ice cream?
Mm-hmm. No.
Hey, excuse me, miss. May I please have a glass of plain flat soda water, please? No syrup or ice cream or nothing in it, please. Just a glass of plain flat soda water.
No. M. Magic. What?
Each man be a better man with the kindness that we give.
yes, we can. I know we can. Yes, we can.
Great gosh, Almighty.
Yes, we can.
And we gotta take care of all the children, little children of the world. Cause they're our only hope for the future, the little bitty boys and girls. We got to
live this land, a better land than the world in which we live.
And we gotta help each man be a better man with the kindness that we give. Gosh, you're mighty.
Oh, yes, we can. I know we can.
I know we can make it.
I know that we can.
I know darn well we can work
oh,
it
we
out.
We can work it out. Oh, yes, we can. Can. Yes, we can. Can. Oh, why can't we? If we want to get together.
Amor? Sí, amor.
We're going home now. Yeah, you're all right.
Hi, Bertha.
Oh, hi, Bert.
What are you doing, huh?
Oh, I thought my pet was sick, so I took her to the doctor, and now we're going home.
Oh, you have a pet. I have pets, too. Yeah. Well, what kind of pet do you have, Bertha?
Oh, why don't you guess, Bert? I'll give you a hint. She's black and white and gray.
Oh. Okay. Black and white and gray. She's a horse. What? What?
And I carried her to the doctor in this box.
Oh, you... well,
that's
then
funny,
she...
Bert.
Yeah, she can't be a horse if she's in that box. Okay, then she's probably a dog or a cat or something like that, a raccoon. Hmm?
And she goes...
She goes... Well, that sounds like a cat to me.
And she eats bread and popcorn and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
And she has two cute, sweet little feet.
2 feet?
Yeah.
Can't be a cat, then, because a cat has 4 feet. Yeah.
And cats don't have feathers either, Bert.
Feathers? Mm-hmm. Oh, you mean your pet is small enough to fit in that box there, has 2 feet and feathers, and eats bread and popcorn and goes... Rrr, rrr. Could your pet... Could it possibly be, Bertha, that you have a... pigeon?
Oh, Bert, you guessed it! You guessed! Yes, Francine is a pigeon. You want to see her? Look.
Oh, yes. Oh, she's beautiful. And she was sick?
Oh, no, the doctor said she wasn't really sick at all. She was just lonely.
Oh. Well, you know, she doesn't have to be lonely anymore. I have pigeons, too.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, look, over there, see? That's Gus. No, down there. Oh. Yeah, that one, that's Gus.
That's Gus?
Yeah, he's one of my pigeons.
Oh.
Yeah, I just brought him down to take a walk in the sidewalk for a change, you know? He likes a sidewalk walk. Yeah. All right.
Look at that.
Yeah, they're friends already. Uh-huh. Look at them, and look at us. One is Francine, one is Gus. Lots of people think they're boring, but we don't, not us. He is gray, and so is she. You like pigeons, just like me. Lots of people think we're silly, but I don't, not me. We go for the same kind of music, any old rousing march will do. We both like the same kind of oatmeal. It's no good without a lump or two. Watch them soar up to the sky. They are flying, so am I. Lots of people just don't understand, but you do, and so do I. You like oatmeal, I do too. You like paper clips, me too. You play checkers, I do too. You like me, and I like you.
Heathcliff, can you hear your own heartbeat?
Sure, Sheila. I can hear it. I know all about heartbeats and how they pump blood all through your body.
How does it work, Heathcliff?
Well, inside your heart, there's a giant foot which pumps up and down, pushing the blood into little sailboats, which are called blood vessels. The blood vessels carry the blood all around the body. At least that's the way mine works.
Heathcliff, you're amazing. But the blood vessels aren't sailboats, they're freight cars. And the locomotive that pulls them goes all around the whole body. Oh, excuse me, it.
Oh, if you won't do that again, I'll tell you how the circulation of the blood really works. Did you know that the blood makes a trip around your whole body in 1 minute? Blood carries food and oxygen to every part of your body, from the top of your head to the tip of your toes. When it's delivered the food to your body cells to help you grow, it picks up things your body doesn't need, like carbon dioxide, and carries them back to your heart by little tubes called veins. The heart then pumps the blood through the lungs to pick up a fresh supply of oxygen, and out of the heart through a larger tube called an artery. An artery is like a main city street that branches into smaller and smaller streets. And imagine, all this going on in only 1 minute.
Sheila, do you have a stopwatch?
The it really knows how it works.
Hey, Well, then, we are going to have a lecture today about cookies. Cookie Monster. I'm doing a lecture about cookies. I'd appreciate it if you'd be very quiet.
But there need cookies.
Yes, yeah, no. Shh. Lecture time. Okay, now, first of all, we're going to talk about the things that are different about these cookies. Now, you take a cookie like this one right here. Now, this cookie here is sort of shaped like a circle. You see this cookie? It's all round like a circle. You see that? No corners, no sides. It is a circle. All right, that's one. Now, let's take a look at this cookie right here. This cookie has four sides and four corners, and all the sides are the same length. So what do we call this? We call this a square. Right, Cookie Monster?
Oh, yeah. Cookie.
Yes, no. Just hold on. Now then, this next shaped cookie right here, this one is shaped like a what? Anybody know what this shape is? This is a triangle, right? It's got three corners and three sides, so it is a triangular shaped cookie.
Cookie.
Yes, now quiet. Shh. Now this last cookie over here, this one has four sides also, but it has two long sides and two short sides. So we call this one...
Delicious.
No, we call it a rectangle. A rectangle, that's what this kind of cookie is called. And now you know how all these cookies are different from each other. Isn't that amazing?
It boggled the mind. Okay, now.
But now I'm going to tell you what's the same about all these cookies.
Oh, Ernie, me no can take this. Me so hungry for cookie.
Well, what's
me got
this,
to go eat.
Okay, what's the same about all these cookies is... that they're all for you to eat, Cookie Monster.
What?
Lecture's over. Help yourself.
Oh, Ernie. You give best lectures me ever tasted. Cookie!
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. I don't know, I just want you to tell you. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. No, don't touch these.
Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. 12.
One way. One way. One way. One way.
Dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. Oh, there's a sign. O-N-E-Y-E. Huh. What kind of sign is that? O-N-E-Y. One-way. One-way!
Sorry,
but... Watch it. Hey, get out of my way! Sorry.
Didn't mean it.
Hey, come!
One way.
Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog, and I'm speaking to you from the studio of that world-famous composer, Mr. Don Music.
I'll never get it up.
He's working on his next big hit song. Pardon me, Don. Don, over here. Kermit the Frog here? Yes, I was wondering if we could hear this song that you're working on.
It's not finished yet. I have to find one last word, but but you could hear what I have so far if you'd like.
Oh, well, yes, we'd like that very much.
All right. Well, it goes like this.
Okay.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Mm-hmm. Merrily, 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 life is but a... I'll never get it. Never, never, no. What is life anyway?
I'm sure I don't know what life is, but, Don, it's certainly a treat just to be able to hear you work, though, you know.
Did you say a treat?
Yes, that's what I said.
Well, that's it.
That's it?
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a treat. There you go. It's beautiful, isn't it? One of my finest so far.
Well, yeah, but treat doesn't rhyme with stream. You said row down the stream.
Of course not. Oh, no. It's got to rhyme with what I need is to find a word that sounds like treat.
That's true.
A rhyme for treat. Mm-hmm. I've got it. Row, row, row your boat gently down the street. Merrily, 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 life is but a treat. There you go, all right, treat and street do rhyme.
But you see, you don't row a boat down the street. See, there's no water in the street, so that... Don.
Of course you don't row a boat down the street.
Yeah, are you okay there?
I'll be all right. It's
kind of hard on the head when you do that, you know.
I know. Wait. I've got it. Okay. If you don't row a boat down the street, then... Row, row, row your car gently down the street.
Car?
Merrily, 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 life is but a treat. There you go. There are cars on the street all the time.
But you don't row them. I mean, you don't row a car. Nobody rows a car. You don't row a car. You don't...
Of course. Of course you don't row a car.
You okay there?
But wait.
What?
Drive, drive, drive your car gently down the street. Merrily, 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 life is but a treat. There you go. What do you think?
I love it.
Drive, drive, drive your car gently down the street. Merrily, 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 life is but a treat.
Drive, drive,
drive your car.
I said drive, street. Drive your car.
Maryland,
down the street.
Drive your car.
Maryland, 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 Maryland. Life is but a treat.
Maryland, Maryland, life is but a treat.
Another instant evergreen from the pen of Don Music.
Hospital, see my new baby brother.
Hi, honey. How are you? Can we kiss? What's this? Huh? Flowers for me? Well, are you ready to go see our little baby?
Sure. We'll get the nurse to bring him over.
There he is, Jamie.
Who's that?
My brother.
That's your brother, right?
What are you going to name him?
Mark.
Mark? Oh, that's a lovely name.
See? How old is he?
How old is he? One day.
One day old.
How old are you?
4 years old.
Ah, there's a big difference, isn't there? Isn't he tiny, honey? You used to be that tiny once.
I know. He'll be bigger than that by the time he gets home. Whose baby is that?
That's somebody else's baby.
My father had to pick me up.
Look at all these little tiny babies.
We saw the baby laying in the crib. He had a blanket wrapped around him. Where are your toes, baby?
His toes is all wrapped up. His toes are all wrapped up.
Papa made so sad. Some of them were sleeping and some of them were crying. Because they don't like to be by themselves. They wanted to be with their mamas.
If he starts to cry, I'll just bring him to you.
You have to be very careful, though.
Because babies are very important.
Look at that funny face.
I want you to come home tomorrow, Mommy.
Okay. Shall we bring the baby?
Bye, baby, Eric.
So I'll bring the baby home in a couple of days, and we'll have lots of fun with him, okay, honey? Can I have a kiss goodbye?
Say goodbye.
Mm. Bye, Mommy.
Bye, honey. Okay. And take care of Daddy. Thank you for the flowers. I will.
Come home tomorrow. Come home tomorrow.
I cannot make a snowman. No matter how I try, there isn't any snow in June or in July. I have a pair of coal eyes and a button for his nose. I do not think a snowman needs any other clothes. I tried to make a snowman out of ordinary ice, but it wasn't like a snowman, and I had to do it twice. I have something for above him and something for beneath. I even have a toothpick, should he want to pick his teeth. I tried to make a snowman out of ordinary sand, but it wouldn't stick together, and I couldn't make it stand. So I've come to the conclusion, and I don't care if you know, that you cannot make a snowman if you haven't any snow.
Did you ever think about all the great things you can do with your mind? Boy, it's really great. For instance, right now, I'm planning on walking through this door. Now, I haven't actually done it yet, but I'm thinking about how I'm going to come over here and open the doorknob, walk through the door. So I'm planning on it. somebody's knocking at the door. Now, I don't know who's knocking at the door, but I can imagine. That's another thing you can do with your mind. Imagine. Yeah, for instance, I can imagine that my mother is knocking at the door. Now, I don't know that that's true, but I can imagine that my mother's knocking at the door. Wait a minute, I just remembered something. Yeah. That's another thing you can do with your mind. Remember, yeah. Now, let's see. Mom told me that she was going to visit Aunt Mildred this afternoon. She told me that this morning, but I can still remember it now. So I don't know who's that knocking at the door. But let's go back to imagining. Yeah. I know. Yeah, I can imagine that there's a big scary monster knocking at the door. Oh, I can imagine that there's a big scary ugly monster knocking at the door. Let's talk about hoping. Let's see. Yeah, hoping's another thing you can do with your mind. And I sure hope that's not a monster. I can imagine that it's a monster, but I sure hope it isn't. I'm not imagining anymore, and I'm not hoping, and I'm not remembering. Now I'm planning again. I'm planning to run!
I just wanted to know if you could come and play with my dollies and me. Oh, well.
M. Nail. M.
And the pig got up and slowly walked away.
Hey, Pajaro,
how are you? Hi there. What you doing? You're hugging a chair there?
Yeah, I'm holding it together like this very tightly because I just glued it, see? And if I let go, it'll fall apart.
Oh, gee.
Yeah. Usually I use clamps, but they're on something else in the shop.
Oh, you're always so smart, Luis. Oh, you know what? That sounds a lot like your phone.
Yeah, wow, I'd answer it, but if I let go of the chair, it'll just fall apart.
Oh, gee, that's a problem.
Big Bird, would you mind answering it for me?
Me?
Yes.
Answer your phone?
Huh?
Oh, gosh, you know, you could always count on me. Just ask and I will do it.
Thank you.
Sure, I'll answer the phone anytime. You can call me up anytime.
Big Bird, the phone.
Sure. Oh, boy. Oh, wow. Did you just see what I did?
What did you do?
I just stubbed my great toe.
Oh.
Did you ever do that? Stub your toe?
Oh, yes. Many times I've stubbed my toe, but Big Bird, the phone, please, the phone.
Oh, well, I'll answer the phone. Even if my toe hurts a lot, I don't mind. Oh, look at the fire engines go. Oh, look, one, the two, three fire engines. Wow, what do you think? Yeah. What do you think the fire is?
They're terrific, but listen, answer the phone, Big Bird. The phone, remember?
Oh, no, I don't think the phone's on fire.
No, answer the phone.
Oh, yeah, sure
answer
I will.
It.
Hey, Big Bird.
Yeah?
Can you run an errand for me?
Oh, me? Sure. Well, no, I can't do it. No, because, you see, I have to answer the phone for Luis. See, he's all tied up. He has to hold on to a chair.
Okay.
But later on, when I'm through helping him, I will come and help
Big
you,
Bird.
Okay?
Oh, never mind. I'll answer it myself. It's for you.
Let's see. The weather in Milpitas should be 49 degrees. And the weather in Chico...
Hey, Bert. Excuse me, Bert.
Hey, does it matter whether or not I put this vase on the little shelf back there or on the big shelf?
It certainly does, Ernie. If you put the vase on the wrong shelf, it'll fall off and break.
Well, which shelf is which, Bert?
Ernie, I'm reading. Can't you see that? Just figure it out for yourself. But be careful. That's my favorite vase, huh?
Oh, okay, Bert. Figure it out. Alrighty.
Let's see now.
Figure it out for myself, huh? Okay, well, let's see. Maybe what I should do is I'll put it on each shelf and see which one it falls off of. No, that's not a very good idea. The vase might break, I guess. I know what I'll do. I'll use my imagination. And I'll imagine what would happen if I put the vase on each shelf, huh? How about that? Well, let's see. Suppose I imagine that I put it on this shelf here, see? Now, that's a little bitty shelf, and it's a pretty big vase here. What would probably happen is the vase would probably tip over and... Vase would probably break. And old buddy Bert would probably say,
Ernie, you broke my favorite vase.
And then he'd probably throw me out of the house.
Ernie, get out.
And it'd probably be cold outside and windy. And I'd be shivering. And it would just be terrible.
Ernie, what's the matter, Ernie?
Oh, Bert, it was terrible. It was
what?
Terrible. I was imagining what would happen if I put this vase on the little bitty shelf back there.
Well, Ernie, if that's so bad, why don't you just imagine what would happen if you put the vase on the big shelf, huh?
Well, that's a good idea, Bert. Okay.
Oh, boy.
Let's see. If I put the vase on this shelf, and the shelf is pretty big, and the vase would fit on it, and it wouldn't fall off, so my old buddy Bert would probably say,
Ernie, you saved my vase. How can I ever thank you?
And you know how impulsive old buddy Bert is. He'd probably throw a party, you know? And there'd be presents and everything like that. He wouldn't have to do it, but he probably would. And he'd probably give me a present like maybe, I don't know, like a toy trumpet, you know? Oh, and we'd all have so much fun, and it'd be great. And it would all be because I put this vase on this big shelf just like this.
Oh, hi, Ernie. You finally put the vase away, huh? Okay, thanks.
Oh, no, Bert. No, don't thank me. You've already done enough.
What?
Not another word, Bert. The party, the trumpet. After all I did was put your vase on the shelf.
He's got bananas, right?
I'm full. I'm fuller. I'm fullest.
I just got here.
Boys and girls, we are going to talk about full. This is a wastebasket. It is full. Perhaps we should talk about empty.
Hello, boys and girls. My cute little assistant, I'm Gordon, just being silly Gordon, and I are going to talk about empty and full.
Hmm? That's right.
And we are going to use this milk and that glass. Now, First, could you put the glass right in front of your teacher, Grover?
Okay. There's your glass.
Nicely done. Now, could you fill the glass with the milk?
Okay.
You're so good at this.
There you are.
Very nice. Milk. Now, next, could you put the straw in the glass?
Okay, Grover. Here's your straw.
Thank you, assistant. Now, here comes the fun part. I, Grover, will drink the milk. And the glass now is full. This is going to be a visual demonstration of full and empty. Here we go. Oh, that was delicious.
Very well done.
You see, the glass was full with milk, but now it is empty.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Now, let us do it once more. Okay? Will you please pour the milk into the glass?
Fill it up again?
Please, cute assistant.
Okay.
All the way there.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
Wonderful. All right, now. Here we go again.
Now it's full.
That is right, assistant.
Right.
It is a full glass. Now, here we go. Ooh. Now, it is empty. The glass is empty. Was that not nice?
Very good.
Should we do it one more time?
Another time, you sure?
Why not? It is delicious. More milk, please.
If you say so.
Yes, cute assistant. You do this very well.
There you are.
All right, now.
Another glass of milk.
That's right. Now, the glass here is full. It is a full glass of milk. All right, here we go now.
Wow.
Oh. Excuse me. All right. Now, this glass is empty.
Now it's empty, right?
Empty, yes. Mm-hmm. You think everybody understood that?
Well, I think so. One last glass,
okay? More milk.
You want another glass of milk?
Just one more milk. I want to make certain that full and empty
This makes
is
four
understood.
Glasses. There you are.
Very good.
Now it's full.
Now it is full. But soon, we know what it will be. Here we go. Oh, dear. It is empty now.
That's
yes.
Right.
I think I might have overdone it, assistant.
That's a lot of milk, Grover.
Well, as you can see, the glass is now empty, and the pitcher is about empty, and the only thing that is,
we've got a little more in here, if you...
Go ahead, why not?
Okay, may as well. Oops.
Okay, here we go. It is now...
Almost full.
Almost full.
Yep. Wow.
And it is now empty.
Now it's empty. How do you feel, Grover?
Now the pitcher is empty, is it not?
Yes, the pitcher is empty, too. That's
yes.
Right.
But do you know what is full? Me.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, cute assistant.
Hi there. I'm a parrot. Do you see me? I'm sitting right over here. See me yet? Look, I'll wink my eye. See that? Okay, I'll give you another clue. I'll move my wing. You still didn't see me? Well, all right. I'll fly around a bit. Then you can see me. Okay, now that you've seen me, I'm going back. Now watch so that you don't forget where I am.
Hey, who wants to do some painting? Anybody? Oh, good. Oh, that's good. Yeah, put on the smock so you don't get paint on your clothes. Uh-oh, a little trouble reaching the buttons, hmm? Hey, hold it a minute. Can you think of a better way to get those smocks buttoned up? Good. That's cooperation. David helps Kim, and then Kim helps David. Yep, that's cooperation. Let's paint.
M. I love the letter M because the word mommy starts with M. We have lots of things around the house that start with M. Like mops, meatballs, and mirrors. The word man starts with M. Daddy's a man. And men have mustaches. Some fun things that begin with the letter M are monsters, meadows, marble, monkeys, and magic. The letter M. I like it.
What's she doing?
I don't know.
It's a machine with numbers.
He's working on the machine too. What's he doing now?
More machines with numbers.
He put the numbers on the paper.
I know what it is. It's a check.
Money!
More money!
I know what this place is. It's a bank.
What's a bank?
A bank is where people go to get money or to save money. That's where they work. In a bank.
We are bank tellers.
Moon. In the dark of the night, the moon shines bright. It shines through the window on me. It helps me see the cat on the wall and the birds asleep in the tree. Moon.
Three of these kids belong together. Three of these kids are kind of the same. But one of these kids is doing his own thing. Now it's time to play our game. Yeah, time to play our game. Take a good look at all these kids now. Can you tell which one's doing his own thing? Which of these kids is doing his own thing? Come on now, can you tell me which one? Can you guess which kid is doing his own thing? Before my song is done, ba-da-da-da-da. Hey, how'd you do? Did you guess which kid was doing his own thing? Well, if you guessed this one, you're absolutely right. Because the other three kids, they're all dancing. But this kid is just reading a comic book and having a good time doing that, so... That's why that's the right answer.
How'd you do, huh?
Lauren, you help me count to 20, okay?
Okay.
I'm going to start first, and you help me. One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Oh, boy. Five.
Six.
Oh, good. Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
11.
12.
You said 12.
Yeah.
Yeah. You said 12, so after 12 comes, what comes after 12?
13.
13?
14.
15?
16.
17?
18.
Oh, boy. Don't help me. Don't help me. You said 18. What comes after 18?
19.
What?
19.
19?
20.
We did it.
You know, Bert, I really don't like soda pop.
Huh?
I only drink soda to get the cap for my bottle cap collection.
You mean you have a bottle cap collection, too?
You do, Bert?
I do, too. Oh, isn't this wonderful? Do you have any Figgy Fizz caps?
Oh, I have lots of Figgy Fizz caps, Bert.
Do you?
Yes.
I have Poom Pop caps.
Extras?
Well,
yes.
Good night, you two.
Extras. Would you
see
like
you
one?
Oh, yes, Bert.
Could I have a Figgy Fizz pop
oh,
cap?
Oh, I have quite a few extras.
How do about you... a banana twirl?
Oh,
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters
I
M
banana twirl,
and N.
But I'll give it to you.
And by the number 12.
How about two Figgy Fizz?
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.